There's not anything that a man wants more than to be respected as a strong man. But strength flows from the almightiness of the one we worship. Let us lift up his name, Almighty, Almighty God, who flows his strength to those that praise him. We can make God any higher than he is. He is exalted, his throne is high. So when we sing, Lord, we exalt you, we are not increasing his rule or dominion of glory. We are saying, Lord, I'm exalting you in my life. I'm saying, you be praised in my life. Be the ruler over all things that concern me. Exalt the Lord. Exalt the Lord. worshiper from the deep of our beings. There was a worshiper named David who said this:
I will not give that which costs me nothing. So when I clap my hands in honor of the Lord, I lift my voice in praise and adoration. Together they become an instrument of war. We applaud your greatness, we applaud your might, and we shout to God in triumph as we set ourselves to fight. Every demon trembles when they hear our voices raised. Join with loud applause of
showing the real significance of applause and worship. Let's sing it now.
I clap my hands to show I'm in agreement with what the Word of God says concerning me. Your King of Kings and Lord of Lords forever. Without applause we come to welcome. Learning just to come into His presence, to let Him pare back the superficialities of our life, to come and deal with us at the deepest dimensions of our being. He invites us there. Come to that table. I just want to be where you are, dwelling daily in your presence.
early in Jesus' ministry, some disciples came to him looking for guidance. How could they get in touch with this man? They said, "Where do you live?" And he said, "Come and see." That's when they came to be where he was, but they found who they were. Continue drawing even nearer.